are so excited to welcome friends of show because you've been on the show a couple times.
Yeah.
We love you, Mike and Nancy. Mike'em.
Thank you.
I'm sad you're not playing for us today, but...
Oh, that's okay. That's I can talk to you, too.
I know. I just love your songs, and I love your sound, and I love your story, and they're going to be playing at the White Hart Renaissance Fair this weekend. It actually is for a few weekends June.
This weekend... Next weekend, it's 3 weekends.
3 weekends.
Yes. Yeah.
And is it the Saturday and the Sunday?
Yes. Saturday and Sunday.
Yes, Saturdays and Sundays. Okay, if somebody's not familiar, which I'm kind of not familiar with this, tell us about the fair.
Tell us about the fair.
Well, it's been there for about 14 years. Mm-hmm. The backstory of is very interesting. The couple came from California to get away from, it became commercialized a little bit. Mm-hmm. So they came here for the artisans, so they could actually celebrate the artisans that are in the business. And the man, that was a good fair, people started coming around, and after the first year, the feller got cancer, Mr. Taylor. And so Di, his wife, took the lead, and everybody came together. So this fair has been 14 years in his memory.
Aww.
For a good way of putting it.
So it's a small fair. If you're used to Renaissance, of course, celebrates the Renaissance. Queen Elizabeth, she's very young at our fair. So we celebrate the Renaissance. We have fencing, and we have...
Storytelling, Alexander James.
Yes, storytelling. We have music, of course, which we are going to be doing.
Yeah,
of course.
No dad jokes. No dad jokes.
No dad, I don't believe you.
No, none. Very little.
We're looking at some fun footage, so we're seeing the music.
Yeah. There's Bruce, yes.
Oh, and dancing. I'm all about the dancing.
Dancing, yeah, they have maypole-style dancing.
Oh,
they have rat pucking. Yeah.
What is that?
It's like golfing with a bag that looks like a rat.
Yeah, we're playing rats in the right now.
Did they really do that with rats in that time?
I don't know.
Maybe.
Flying rats. But they play it. They at falconry.
Oh.
There's a little bit. Dancing.
I love that dancing.
It's a smorgasbord of delight.
Yes.
As far as the Renaissance goes, you never know what you're really going to get.
Out in the middle of the woods, so there's no cars going around, so you really feel like you're... And that time period, you know, the 1500s.
Yeah, it's a village fair.
It's really hard to get to, so please Google the address.
Where is it?
Outside of Hartville.
Yes, okay. The community that just got hit, and they're supporting that, too. That's their community.
Yeah.
White Hart, it's 450 acres. They don't utilize all of it. It's partially a hard site. And what I mean by that is some fairs are completely built with buildings.
Right, yeah.
This is partially. Corvus Moon Pottery is a sponsor, and they have actually got a kiln out there where he does the product right there, making pottery, and they have a bakery.
I believe they're going to have blacksmithing.
Blacksmithing.
Just step back in the old times.
So basically, you are stepping back to the Renaissance times, like a regular Renaissance fair, without all of the, I was reading the website, without all of the sponsorship and corporateness that goes along with some of them. Keeping it local, and you're keeping it very business out of it. Yeah. Just enjoy the time.
It's a good time. You get to meet new friends, make old ones. It's our first fair. We call it our home fair. When you have a fair that you started at. Oh, as a matter of fact, I got something for you and Kelly.
Oh, you do? Okay. Yeah. What have you got?
This is a Caricatures by Bill Bosch. These are picks. I have a pick punch, and I got one for you, too.
Oh, wait. I'm going to try to show this to the camera. It's very small, but I hope you can see
it's
this.
It's a caricature of Nancy and I at our very first fair. We didn't know that he was doing it.
Look how cute that is.
And he's a local artist. He also works for Bass Pro.
Yeah.
And he just showed up one day with this, so we had somebody put it on a pick for us. And
that is so cute.
I gave one to Gage, and I got some extra ones for everybody else. And
thank you so much. I love this.
That's a memorial of our fair. And like I said, for Mr. Taylor, like I said, it's the love of a community that's keeping this thing going.
How long did he live so he could see the fair?
He only got the first year.
Oh, the first year.
He was actually involved in hiring people to come back. And I mean, they were coming from California, and Kansas City's a big fair. And these people have been trying to keep it going. And, you know, it ebbs and flows.
Right.
Like a lot of things in life. Mm-hmm. But you definitely got to come out to the fair.
Check it out.
We got fairies. We got, wings flying around.
And you have crafts, which that really interests me. Especially
made right there, man.
Crafts of the days of yore. You know, how they made things is really cool. Like, we're lucky. We have a lot of tools that we can use today, but seeing how they made it in the old days, that's just, like, mind-bending to me.
Well, that's where they invented that first scam that came along.
What was the scam?
Chainmail. Dad joke!
I told you there'd be dad jokes. Do you recommend people dress up? Because when I think of Renaissance Fair, I think of the attire. Do you have to?
No, you don't have to. It's all according to what you want to do and be more comfortable. But if you want to dress up, oh, gosh, yeah.
Yeah. And what's funny is people sometimes they'll come and they'll start adding accoutrements. They'll see something
they like. Yes, there will be costumers there.
Yeah, they have costumers.
Costumes. Vests.
Top hats?
Top hats, all kinds of hats. Feathers.
I did notice in some of that, because I know that Kelly loves steampunk. And I saw steampunk in that video. Is that allowed?
Yes. What's going on is a revolution.
It's reinventing.
It's melding.
I like that.
Yeah,
I like
we're not purists. We're not button counters.
You're merging it, and I love it.
Yeah.
That's right.
Okay, so one more time. If somebody wants to come, do you have to get tickets ahead of time? Can you get them right there at the door?
Right there, yeah.
And what are the weekends again?
This weekend, next weekend, and the next weekend.
So three weekends of June. Yes. Check out the White Hart Renaissance Fair. I love you guys.
I love you. We'll come back.
You're not doing anything today
from
10 to 12? Steam Engine Republic.
That's why we're dressed like this.
Okay, gotcha.
We're gonna be playing.
And next time you come on the show, you're not allowed to come unless you play.
Okay. Oh, you are so sweet. Thank you very much.
You have to play. Okay? Okay. Is it a deal?
Yes.
It's a deal.
Let's shake on it.
Okay.
Let's shake on it. Okay.
What comes in a bunch? Well, I got a hunch of bananas. Yeah, let's get in the chicken.
I love it. Check out the Renaissance Fair. Coming up, Chris Luzan of the Luz is here with the weekend movie news. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back. Oh, I like that. That was like Bonanza, right?
Yeah, yeah. What comes in a bunch? Well, I got a...